Hey, I'm Novillennial doing some test plays today. So I'm going to be running your map here, Bound 2. Let me just look at my notes here. Okay, very first map. Hope you're having fun with it. That's really exciting. Just reading here. Any constructive criticism? So how's the difficulty? And you might be adding a harder expert version. Okay. So we'll jump in to it in a second. To let you know a little bit about me, because of course, as you kind of mentioned in your thing, I'm an expert plus player. So please do take everything with a grain of salt. I don't normally play normal maps myself. But one, I've been doing a lot of test plays of lower difficulty maps. But also I'm doing a lot of down mapping myself. So I've really been getting into like the lore of like how to down map and stuff. Plus I've been having my dad test play my maps. So my general rule of thumb when I play normal level difficulty of maps is to kind of pretend what would my dad say when he's playing it. So that's kind of the basis I'm going to use, as well as if I see any things that are sort of glaring errors. And I'll try to point out things because, yes, there are definitely acceptable patterns and acceptable things that you can do with normal difficulty maps. So if you haven't read the wiki, I think I said you did, definitely read it. So I am going to link the wiki section on down mapping and gauging difficulty because it has an amazing table that just completely summarizes good pattern practices and what you should avoid. Things, for example, like what your note jump speed and jump distance should be. So looking at your numbers here, 10's okay. I usually map my normal levels at 11. That jump distance is really high. Like I probably wouldn't go over about 25 because, for example, your reaction time is like 1600, which is, I think, really high for a normal level difficulty map. You probably want just over 1000 for your reaction time personally. So that's it. I'm going to keep it the same. I'm just going to jump in and see where we're at. And if I have to come in and take down the jump distance, I will. So I'm going to start now. But otherwise, yeah, we'll just kind of see. Whoop. Okay. So right off the bat, that's what we call a hot start. You want to have about 1.5 to 2 seconds of nothing, like no, ideally even no music, but definitely no player interactions for the first 1.5 to 2 seconds. Otherwise, you're basically going to jump scare people and they won't be prepared to do that. Second thing I'll point out with that is not a great way to start the map. Like most players are going to start with their hands in the up position like this. So generally you want to start with some type of a downswing or at least a forehand movement, which technically that was, right? Like that was a forehand movement coming in like that, but no players are going to start with their arms out. So I had to very quickly, especially because it was a hot start, jump my hands out. And that was quite uncomfortable to play. Also just in general, that pattern might like the twice in pattern might be a little bit too hard for normal level difficulty in general. But yeah.
Uh-huh, honey. All the mother niggas lame and you know it now. When a real nigga hold you down, you're supposed to drown.
Yeah, so those are also all resets because basically when you play and a note in like that, that's going to play like a down for most people, right? Because like horizontal notes still are going to have vertical parity to them. And as a general, I mean, I guess you could play it up, but most people are going to play it swinging down. So that ends up being a reset there on the other down note that's following it. So that is technically allowed on normal, especially because there is a big gap between the two notes. But I just wanted to point that out because I feel it felt unnecessary. Like, I think it would just be more satisfying to swing them down and then go up down, I think, on the next two doubles. Just feels to me like it would maybe be a little bit more satisfying to play. I think that was a vision block there.
Bam.
Yeah, these are vision blocks. That's a reset on red.
What you doing?
And again, resets are allowed on normal, but as a general rule of thumb, you don't typically want to reset so that both notes are up, right? Because like when players are going to self-reset, like normal players do self-reset a lot, meaning like when they play a down note, they're automatically going to put their hands back up, almost like in preparation for the next one. But basically, when you play an up note, no one's going to then go back down and let their hands drop. So the reset's just a little bit more jarring when the two notes are both up notes than when if the two notes are both down notes. So again, it's not technically forbidden, but it's just going to make it a little bit more on a Thursday. Awkward.
She said she only here for a girl birthday. They yeah. order champagne, but still look thirsty.
Yeah, and you definitely want to watch your vision blocks, which if you look in the map checker, it'll point that out. It doesn't mean you necessarily have to fix them, but you just want to be mindful of that.
Start a fight club, Brad reputation. I turned the nightclub bad at a basement.
Yeah, some resets there too.
Your ass keep complaining. How you gonna be mad on vacation? Dutton winding around all these Jamaicans. This that prime shit. This that what we do, don't tell your mom shit. This that red cup all on the lawn shit. Got a fresh cut straight out the salon, bitch.
As a general rule of thumb, you want to avoid diagonal notes in normal. Like, this is very spaced out. You could probably get away with it. But I also think it would just look cool as a horizontal, but just something to keep in mind. Well, wow.
Uh-huh, honey. Close your eyes and let the word paint 1,000 pictures. One good girl is worth 1,000 bitches. Bam!
So that's a reset there. The other thing I was going to mention too is, so I'm trying to think how to word it. So like having, cause like you're doing kind of the same mapping for all of the sounds. And the problem is it's a little bit repetitive. So that's it. Like, I don't hate the idea. Like, I get what you're doing with the doubles and the arcs there, but I'd like to see just a little bit more variety through it. So not everyone has to be in down up, right? Like, or you could do something like have it like over here, like move it to one side and then have it come over to the other side, right? Like to get a little bit more sway here. I'm very central and I'm doing the same motions over and over again. And I think, like, again, you don't have to change like the placement of the blocks, but well, sorry, you don't have to change the timing of the blocks, but I think like just changing it up a little bit, right? So sometimes you do a double over here and then you come over here. And then next time you do it, your center and then up and down. And then the next time you're to the left and up and down. Or you could even have it like swing around, like have a down here that swings to an up over on this side. I think that would just make it a little bit more interesting, right?
Bam.
Yeah, so the reset there on red, and again, it's the double up reset is the one that feels awkward to me.
After that, give you something to drink. Step back, can't get spunk on a mink.
Also, that would also get rid of some of the vision blocks there. That arc was weird, because you had the arc trailing to nothing, which is fine, but I think you had it trailing to an up note, and that arc just looked weird. So I would fix that.
Hey, you remember where we first met? Okay,
that's probably a little bit of an unfriendly pattern for normal difficulty. And same, I would make these horizontal notes as well instead of diagonals. Definitely vision block there.
Hey, yo, we made the Thanksgiving. So, hey, maybe we can make it to Christmas. She asked me what I wish for on my wish list. Have you ever asked your bitch for other bitches? Maybe we could still make it to the church steps. But first, you gon' remember how to forget.
Vision block there too.
After all these long ass verses, I'm tired, you tired, Jesus wept.
That, again, diagonal note was a little awkward. Yeah, I like that pattern, but that's a little unfriendly for normal. Having it be like a little wrist roll there. Vision block there. Although if you reduce the jump distance, it probably wouldn't be. I like the arcs through that section.
Bam.
That one there in particular, I wouldn't have that reset, like where you're going up and then up, because that's very quick. But otherwise, yeah, like I think there's a lot of good stuff there. Like I said, I think the big thing is I want to see more variety in the notes, like moving back and forth a little bit. Watch out for the vision blocks and watch out for the resets, especially when they're both in the upwards direction. You didn't have any notes in the top row, which is good for normal. You don't want them. Just throwing it out there that if you do put notes in the top row, to make them dots, because your normal difficulty players are going to swing more wildly at them, and it can be hard to hit them accurately otherwise, or they might just completely panic and hit them down, even if you intend them to hit them up. So you didn't have any, but I thought I would just mention that. Because you were talking about up mapping, I guess. Obviously do it however you want, but I think if you're going to up map, I want to hear some representations about what Kanye West is actually like, the lyrics of the song, because I like what you did for the normal, that it was more like the background vocals that you were mapping here. And I think that's normal for normal difficulty. But I think that there's a lot of sounds that were just kind of ignored in that map. I'm assuming because it was the normal difficulty, that I think you could have a lot of fun with playing around with, and I think would make that very interesting, if you're going to upmap it. So yeah, like a lot of good stuff to work with there. Let me see if there's anything else you specifically wanted to ask about. No, I mean, I think I said everything I needed to say while I was doing it. But check out the description for the video, because if I think of something else, I'll post it there. But I am definitely going to post the link to the map checker and to the Beat Saber modding group wiki, because I definitely think you should read it. It's a game changer, like especially if you're going to be mapping lots of difficulties, the down mapping, engaging difficulty, and the best pattern practices are going to just make your maps a lot more solid. It's definitely worth the read. You'll get so much out of it and stuff. So yeah, hope that helps.